minus 6.91 minus 6.91, so it means that it is inclined at an angle of 45 degrees to the horizontal. So that is the reason why I have given these accelerations. And in the models, I have considered viscosity as realizable k epsilon scalable wall functions. And regarding the wall functions, I think you can refer to the video which I have kept in my channel. You'll get a clear information about the different wall functions. And in the radiation model, I have activated discrete ordinate with given angular discretization as 2, pi division as 2, theta pixel, pi pixel as 1, 1. So what exactly discrete ordinate model is? I'll just open the user guide for you. So in the discrete ordinate model, so if any incoming radiation is coming, so that is the amount of intensity of radiation coming, and that radiation would be add up if any gas also emit any radiation. So apart from the incoming radiation, there is a possibility that the gas which is present in between any two objects can also release some radiation. So that would also add up to the radiation, and there can be absorption and scattering loss to that radiation. So these are two inputs, or two in, and this is one out. So any scattering addition also can take place. So 1, 2, 3 ins and one out. One out is due to the absorption scattering loss. So now the net radiation which is in and something is lost due to absorption scattering, and the remaining will go out. So this is a radiation transfer equation which need to be solved for the energy. So you can see, so these are the ins, this is the in, this is one in, so that should be equals to the net outs. The total ins should be equals to the net variation. So you can see, so the total ins should be equal to the net outs. So the or else the energy or radiation will not be conserved. It need to be conserved. So the energy need to be conserved. So these are the energy equation that will be solved, or the radiation equation that need to be solved. So this radiation equation should be solved along with the energy equation. But energy equation, radiation equation will not solved parallelly. So it can be solved in a coupled manner or uncoupled manner. So in I am using just an uncoupled manner. In uncoupled manner also, I have just mentioned that energy iterations for radiation iteration. So for one radiation iterations, there should be 10 energy iterations that need to be solved. So if once this equation is solved, after that, with the given amount of intensity or energy radiation, 10 times or 10 steps or 10 iterations of energy equation will be solved. So that is the important thing which we need to take care. So if you want to have a better convergence for this single radiation iteration, you can keep 20 to 30 energy iterations. So these are the DO model equations that it will be used, or it will be solved here in the three-dimensional, as you can see. So this it has again same old conservation principle with respect to momentum, continuity, or energy equation. And the other points what we see here is I've already mentioned in the materials, you can see the coefficients. So I have considered air as my model. I'll just open it for you. Yeah, so absorption coefficient, scattering coefficient. So these are the two terms that you can see here in radiation transfer energy equation. This is a scattering coefficient, what we can see, and this is absorption coefficient. A plus alpha sigma s. So those are the two coefficients that we need to consider when you have absorption scattering loss due to gas present or molecules present in between the or in the medium. So that all will need to take care. But as of air, it doesn't have any absorption scattering coefficient, very low. But for time being and for to understand that importance, I've given a coefficient of 0.2 and 0.2. The scattering phase fraction also, phase function also have taken isotropic. You can also go for anisotropic. And the refractive index as 1. Refractive index need not be 1, it can be 0.9 or 0.8. So you can vary that. So all the variations you can see here, what exactly refractive index and its significance in the radiation transfer energy equation. This is the energy equation or radiation energy equation that need to solve once for 10 times of energy. So if once radiation equation is solved, 10 times of energy equation or energy iterations would be solved for the convergence. So you can see here, right? So now this is the theory, bit theory behind the things. And the next part, I just want to let you guys know is about this theta divisions and pixelations. So I'll just go to the theory guide once again. So you can find the user guide and theory guide in the internet itself. So yeah, when you are trying to resolve this energy or radiation in the space, in the air, so the incoming should be equal to outgoing, so that there will be no imbalance. But it need not be equal, because in tetrahedron type meshes, so there will be overhanging control angles. So you can see here, this is the extra angles that are not equivalent with respect to the next or outgoing directions. Incoming directions are not equal to the outgoing directions. So you can see here, essentially control angles can straddle the control volume faces, so that they are partially incoming and partial outgoing to phase. So it is not perfectly correlating. So this is a 3D example, you can see. So it is partially incoming and a partial outgoing. In that kind of terms, so you can have the partial volume split it into the pixels. So this is the control volume phase, that partial phase in which you need to resolve into small pixels. So the small pixels can cover that area so that it would be equally it will not be partial anymore, it will be full, because we have turned that huge volume that is partial now into small volume that is complete through the help of pixel. So that pixel resolution would depend on your mesh type and the space what you're considering in the domain or geometry. So for time being, has given theta pixel as 1 and 1, but it need not be 1 and 1, it can be increased by an amount. And the theta and phi exactly are nothing but the, you can see, so these are the solid angles which covers the entire domain. I'll just show it to you. Yeah, so this is theta and this is phi. So for each theta and phi, there is a pixels. These are the pixels. So each overhanging control angle is divided into n theta phi plus n theta p cross n phi p pixels. So this pixel resolution would make the partial resolved angle into single complete angle. It is like something which is overhanging or which is not completely filled. We split that into small parts. So now each small part would completely enclosed, right? So now partially is turned into complete by splitting into small pieces. So that is an insight into Deva model. And of course, the scattering coefficients and all those things, is it anisotropic or isotropic, that you can mention in the your model, right? And I'm using here solar ray tracing model. So I went into a Delhi global position. So Delhi global position is 77.1 longitude, 28.7 latitude, time zone is 5.5. This is the day of the year, time of the day, and it's month and the minute. This is the things I have selected, and I have selected the inclination of panel in this way. The orientation is present, so you can go here. So this is a positive x, negative y. This is the sun direction, if the sun is present. So now x is along the east and minus y is along the north. So when you try to rotate this panel, so now the east, so which is tend to be east, now it has both x as well as z coordinates. It has x as well as z. So x and z are 1 and 1. But y would remain, or minus y would remain a minus y only, because you are rotating about the origin. So but x and z would now present for the east way, because it is turned, or it was it came into the xz or zx coordinate. So this point would have both z as well as x, but this point, or as you turned about the origin, it will not change. East would be in the positive x direction and north will be again in the minus y direction. So when you try to rotate about the origin in this inclination fashion, the east would now have both z as well as x, but whereas north will not change, it will be along in the minus y direction. So now for east, you can have both z and x as 1 1, for the north only y as 1. So it is a inclination of the or mesh orientation of the solar panel. So I'll click on apply. On clicking on the apply, this is the amount of normal irradiation you're getting, and what is the vertical, what is the horizontal diffuse solar irradiation you're getting, and what is the ground reflected solar irradiation you're getting. Everything would be calculated by the Fluent itself. So now click OK. So if you don't want to use solar calculator, you can just untick this and you can directly give your values. That is again entirely different, right? So click on OK. Sunshine factor is 1, so there are no clouds, I'm assuming. So now everything is done. In the cell zone conditions, I'm just going to fluid, and for that fluid has given air as my media, right? Air as my media. And in the boundary conditions, I have given the inlet. You can just, I've already shown you. So one side is inlet, other side is outlet, this side is outlet, and everything here walls. So with the velocity of 2 m/s, turbine with intensity and viscosity as 5 and 10. So I just want to show you the wall conditions, what I have considered in this one. So except panel wall, remaining all the walls are adiabatic. So in the adiabatic, I have considered the thermal or emissivity as value 1, and with radiation as opaque and diffuse fraction as 1, without participating in solar ray tracing. So all the adiabatic walls will not participate in solar ray tracing. So I'll just show you some description about these opaque walls. So opaque walls, or some amount of radiation is incidented and some amount is get diffused and reflected, and the remaining amount is absorbed plus emitted. So now these are the things what we need to consider. Emission from the wall surface depends on the wall temperature, and diffused reflected energy would depend on the this diffuse fraction as well as emissivity of the wall, and the specular reflected energy wall depends on the diffuse fraction as well as emissivity of the wall, and the amount of heat or amount of radiation that is getting acting on it, and absorption is the remaining amount of energy which is not getting emitted, that is epsilon W into QN. So for this we need to know about epsilon value and FD value. We need to give it as input to the fluent. That is already given here. So diffuse fraction is nothing but FD, and epsilon value is nothing but your internal emissivity. So those two values have given, and any fluid that is adjacent to the walls, yes, these kind of opaque conditions you can give. And but in the panel wall, what I have done is I've said that it should participate in solar ray tracing, so that incident radiation will be incidented onto that panel, and I've given a diffuse fraction of 0.5 and the momentum as thermal emissivity as 0.8. so the difference is among the both walls is one doesn't participate in solar ray tracing and the other one participates in solar ray tracing with these boundary conditions. You can get this opaque boundary conditions in your manual itself. So I'll just again discuss incident. On when the incident radiation is there, there is something to get diffused and something to get reflected and something to get absorbed. And out of absorbed, yeah, there is every chance that wall it can emit. So that is Q emission. So all these would take as input for the wall. So now I'll just try to run the simulation. These are the boundary conditions which you need to give. I have given. Just initialize it and run. I'll just initialize hybridly. In the hybrid initialization itself, you can understand whether your solution will converge or not. Because hybrid initialization is one part like treating entire domain into very core structure and trying to solve. So yeah, and after 10 iterations, you are getting very low residuals. It is gradually decreased from minus 8 to minus 14. So it does mean that your setup and mesh or everything are in a good condition. So it has every probability that it would converge. So now I'll just try to run it. As I already mentioned, for one DO iterations, 10 energy iterations would need to solve. So you can see here, DO intensity would remain constant for 10 iterations of the energy iterations. So for 10 energy iterations, DO radiation is only 1. So for every 10 iterations, it has a change. You can see here. And just stop for time being. We'll just check the counters, how exactly they're looking. So this is the in. This is the out. So inside, as it is at a 300 Kelvin, it can take more amount of heat, but as the temperature rises, it can take only low amount of heat. That's the reason why one side is green, other side is red, and you can feel the difference here, right? So these are the temperature profiles of the air which is below the solar panel, which is taking the heat from the solar panel. So this length what I have considered is in just very low, it is like 15 centimeters. If you can increase the length and all those things, yeah, you can get a perfect shape and the perfect required simulation, because as I am constrained academic version, only 50,000 note count. So thank you guys, please do subscribe the channel and encourage me in doing more number of videos. If you have any comments and if you require any videos, please let me know in the comments channel. Thank you.